Ready to go now.
Alright, we're going to prep the right foot. The reason for this is because we try to wash off all dirt, bacteria, or microorganisms that might be on the skin. We can't make it sterile, but we can get it pretty clean. I'm putting on sterile gloves to do this procedure. Our little patient is asleep. So this prep, there's a scrub and then there's a paint that you use in prepping. This is the paint, it's put on sponge sticks. The scrub is put on sponges that we scrub his foot with first. We're going to put a sterile drape under his leg. But once I get started, I'll have to, can't put his leg back down once I pick it up. Actually, because he's such a little one, I'm going to start at his toes so I can get those cleaned off so I can pick his foot up. I don't have to make a mess.
That's okay. A sloppy prep is a good prep.
Now that I've lifted his foot, I can't let it down. I got to keep it up. But now those drapes that are dirty and contaminated. Always start at the incision site, so I'm going to scrub there pretty good because he's going to make his incision here. Actually, while doing this, you try not to go over the same area twice or go backwards. It's going to be my last little scrub here, and then I'm going to paint. It's called painting next. This is a towel to dry his foot off first, and then I'm going to paint. Can't get it open. He's a little one. Next, I'm taking the sponge sticks. And I'm going to do what's called painting. With painting, you can only get one direction. You can't come back and go back over it. He's so little, it goes all over his whole foot. The paint I'm going to leave wet, that's doctor's preference, and they'll drape. Mm-hmm.